Hey guys, Brendan here. Just wanted to drop a quick little disclaimer in the front of this video. What you're about to watch is from the Drop-in Dropouts archives. It's from pre-G-Sides. It was when we had even less resources than we have now, when Scott and I mainly were trying to get a gaming channel going. So that said, quality will probably differ a little bit. Audio, video, chroma key, face cam, all that stuff is going to vary. But if you guys are okay with that, enjoy it for what it is. If you like some of the stuff, let us know, and maybe we'll continue some of these series in the future. Who knows? But there's your warning. Enjoy.
Actually,
the last screen was subtitles, and this
yeah,
is voice.
Yeah, what language do you want in?
Oh man,
I kind of
Deutsch.
Yeah, I mean that or like
don't
Japanese.
Make my ears bleed, please.
You know, you just I don't know. Okay. I don't know. Is that
no?
Never mind. All right,
just keep moving.
What are we doing?
I think Japanese, maybe. I think that would be fun. Yeah.
I played through it in English, and the English voice actors aren't bad, but they're, you know.
Let's do Japanese. Let's do it.
Yeah, right. I'm down.
We have English subs. I can survive.
I don't.
Television?
Yeah.
Well, it's too late to change any of that.
Home
ever,
theater.
Now.
What does that even mean? Like, I mean, you still use a TV in a home theater.
I think it depends on if you're eating popcorn or not.
Oh, how do they know?
Well, you have to tell them.
There's like paperwork that comes with this, dude.
Oh, it's telling me what it looks like when it's saving. I have to hit next.
It's not.
Has this episode started yet?
That's. So,
it's getting frustrated now. It's like, just start playing
just
the game.
Push buttons.
It showed you what it looks like when it's
saving.
Look,
there saving. It is. There it is. We know what it is.
Okay, we do.
So the first thing right. It does is tricks you.
What do you mean?
It shows you what it looks like. Yeah, we're probably just stupid, but
let me get this thing on. All right,
let's. Moogle Chocobo Carnival is open.
Yeah, that's
download the holiday pack
DLC sort
of. Get your passport on.
All right, we're starting. We're actually starting this.
We are. Well, we synced, so we're rolling.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Well, we've been.
Hi everyone.
Hello.
This is Final Fantasy 15.
Yes, it is.
I'm Greg.
I'm Scott.
And I'm Brendan. And there's no game to load, so we're going to start a new game see how this is. Well, I've actually, in the interest of transparency, I've finished this game already. But it's your first time seeing this?
I've seen you play it for like an hour, maybe.
Yeah.
This is my first time seeing the game in person, so
right,
I'm excited.
Right. You've seen her profile picture online, but now the first date tutorial offers interactive... I don't need it.
All right.
So are you guys aware that there's also an anime and a feature length movie?
I saw
like for this game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, surrounding this game. Yeah.
I saw Kingsglaive. I didn't really pay attention to it much. It was no Advent Children.
No, I'd agree with that, but I mean, they did get Sean Bean and Lena Headey and Aaron Paul.
There was a ton of big cast on that movie,
yeah,
surprisingly.
But yeah, I think I like the anime better, actually. But,
but it looks good.
I don't know, though. I got into both of them before I played the game, and it kind of set up expectations for me. And I don't know, you guys will see. But it's not a bad game. It just like animes are like really character driven. While games are typically more gameplay driven, so.
Whoa. All right. Well,
It's gonna get hot.
It's gonna get hot. Noctis.
Lucius
Callum. Who's that guy? He's gross.
He should shave.
He should do something about something. I mean, is he wearing clothes?
Him? I was like, let me get a little closer. No, I can't.
Nope.
I can't find out if he's wearing just a jock strap or what.
Prompto.
I didn't realize they have last names.
Why?
We're already making our choice to go with the Japanese voices.
Yeah, except we haven't gotten any subtitles yet, which I set up. So we're just going to have to do some guesswork
get
until
I can
get
to
them.
It's fine. We can use like context clues.
They must be talking about how hot it is.
In those dark clothes, dude, that's all that's on their minds.
Right? I mean, firemen wear coats.
Yeah.
They're just firemen.
Well, that's what I first thought. Like, that guy, his house was on fire. Like, the responding.
It was that fat guy's fault.
We're trying to help you. Stop resisting.
Also, holy shit, you're huge.
Oh, man, though. The CG. No subtitles. Can I? Nope.
Oh. This hurts.
It looks like we'll be doing the translations.
No, we're not.
Not even gonna venture.
No.
That.
I mean, it's better than trying to imitate another language. Mm. I guess. Poorly. Got that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we know what that means.
I have played this. I could totally try and recall what they're saying.
Just give us the gist of what's going on when we're totally lost, at least.
No, you don't want to hear that. All right. I forgot. I like just finished the game. I know there's a point here where there's a close up on his face and he says like walk tall my son, and like it's a big emotional moment.
Oh, okay.
And but everything else, I think they're just like, you gotta go, and he's like, I don't really wanna, but I guess I do.
He's going to get married, right?
Like, yeah, okay, so he's going to Alticia to marry Luna, who is the oracle in this, like, universe.
Right.
And he's the prince, he's the king.
And the baby Noctis.
Though you play, like, 99% of the game as him this age.
Man, subtitles not being there.
Yeah,
really?
Thanks, hurting it.
Square Enix.
Well, I definitely hit English, right?
I'm pretty sure we hit the right thing.
Yeah, it might have been like something in the options I should have done back at the title screen.
That's all right. Well, we'll get somewhere.
I'll
Someone knows what we did wrong.
I
can like. Just get this cutscene, recapture this cutscene with fucking subtitles, and I'll just put them.
No, the audience is dealing with this.
All right, fine.
Hey, achievement, trophy,
look,
whatever.
Look how much I've done.
Oh, man.
An accomplishment worthy of a trophy.
Wait, is that the game?
Yeah.
Well, thanks for joining us.
I know what that means.
They fucking burned, yeah. They burned up their budget
is
on that
real?
CG. Like,
oh, yeah.
What? Yeah.
So,
Oh no, it's not over. Look at that.
Oh, nice.
Wow, good
bonus
game.
Round.
Good game.
Oh yeah.
I didn't do that.
I'm already enthralled.
These loading screens, man, are riveting.
Much better than Skyrim's.
Well,
actually totally untrue.
Yeah, except you're sitting on the Skyrim screen for like 20 minutes.
No, I mean, we're playing this on like a vanilla PS4. It's not the PS4 Pro. I think you get some improvements on load times on PS4
sure you
Pro.
Do.
Oh yeah.
But
sure you do.
But they're not at the level of being brutal, but they're long.
Well, I see this load bar creeping and I'm starting to regret what I said.
What'd you say?
That this is not as bad as sitting through a Skyrim screen.
Even in Skyrim, though, at least they give you something to play with.
True.
Like,
yeah,
this. I can
true.
Move this around. This is like, hey, do you want to read?
Helmet now.
I know this is why you play video games, because you don't get enough of books.
We obviously can't read because none of us have read this yet.
No. Oh, yeah. And that would tell you kind of what you missed. Yeah. Oh, shit. Man,
this is good. This isn't in Japanese.
Go Bears.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, that's weird. No, wait, that makes sense.
I don't know.
This is the longest loading screen of my up. Okay, I might have a chance here to turn on subtitles. Or if it just gives us subtitles, I'm actually going to be pissed.
I'm kind of thinking that's what's going to happen.
It's just going to start him off late.
You don't need him for the cinematic. Man. Here it comes.
What? Hey, come on.
All right. Ah, I still can't. Oh, this is torture. Why did we ever pick Japanese?
Because
I know in the long
does the audience gonna, need this like cutscene?
The car broke down. They have some playful animosity going on between them.
Because they're all bros.
Yeah.
They're driving in a really nice car.
Like a future Audi.
That broke down.
Yes.
All right, push.
This is...
It might have run out of gas, which is like...
Who does
It's like
that?
One of the, yeah, the most incompetent things yeah. you can do. Like, unless
these
you
kids,
have...
Like 15? Like, how are they driving?
The fate of the world is in these kids' hands.
Yes!
And you start the game in the car. Pushing a dead car.
Right, subtitles.
Let's get subtitles.
Ah, look at that.
Oh, nice.
So I guess even if you select the subtitles...
The option was English text, so that doesn't necessarily mean, which is what I selected before the game started.
Yeah. Okay.
So we should be good. Yeah, we should be good. I'm just looking real quick.
We should
quick.
Have just All done right. the smart thing and just picked English voices, but whatever. We fixed it.
I don't know.
Deal with it, audience. Be happy.
Oh, look at that. There's words down there.
Nice.
Words. We know what they're saying now.
It can be cinematic with the camera.
Oh, man. Beautiful.
It is beautiful, actually.
Is that...
This is... You cannot say...
In the morning? Is that what that means?
Yes.
That's an animal.
Yeah. No, you can't say this game doesn't look good. Like, you can have your complaints about it. You can have your little, you know, pet peeves. But you can't say it doesn't look good.
I don't know, man. You know what has the best graphics?
Oh, Jesus. What, Scott? What has the best graphics? Is it a live-action movie? Are you going to say that again?
Transformers 4?
No, dude, those graphics were subpar.
And those actually were graphics.
Rain Man had the best graphics
in
gaming history.
If I go look up later and find that there is a Rain Man game...
I don't know how I'd feel about that.
I'll leave the channel. Like,
of all the movies
the channel,
that get
play.
Names, like, Rain Man, I don't know.
Oh, they also got Florence and the Machine to do a cover of Stand By Me. I can't quote me on that. I don't know if she did it specifically for the
game.
No,
you're right.
I know it's Florence and the Machine, though, because I watched
correct,
the credits.
You are correct, because they play that song in the TV advertisements for this game.
Dude.
Yeah.
I didn't really see any TV spots for this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I saw like one or two a while back, like a month before they released it, I guess.
No, they've been out for, I've been seeing them recently, for sure. And it's the Florence and the Machine cover.
Okay, so this episode is absolutely going to run long because we suck at subtitles and nothing has happened yet.
As...
Oh, wait, something's about to happen.
Oh, something
happened.
Hello.
I love you, Japan.
Hammerhead.
Oh, I'm like really glad for the Japanese voices now because that just makes this.
Yeah,
what does
actually.
That tell you about all of us sitting in this room right now?
Actually, though, her Japanese voice is like a million times more tolerable than her English voice. Have you heard it?
Yeah.
It's like a really thick, like, southern drawl, but it just doesn't fit with the rest of the world. Nothing wrong with the accent. It's just...
out of place.
Yeah.
Didn't your daddy tell you? Who the hell is this guy?
Well, he's got the typical anime authoritative voice.
Sid!
Ouch, burn. If they hadn't already given him a name, that should have been what they called him in the credits.
Savage old man.
Maybe something about cars in there, just so you're like, who the...
Savage old man car.
That's what I want my car to be describable as.
Savage old man car. What kind of car would that have to be? Like
an SS. but like from like the 60s.
I'm imagining like a station wagon.
It'd be like an Oldsmobile or something.
But how
like,
is that savage?
With like spikes on
yeah,
it.
Yeah, oh, I was just thinking that.
I got you.
Like a plow.
The hubcaps with the blades.
Go Mad Max with an Oldsmobile. Oh wow, I hit talk and she talked to me. I love video games.
Man. Well,
attractive.
I need a button prompt.
Hit the like hang out at my place button.
Invite her over by him. Invite her over by him.
Play cool button.
Okay, right. What the fuck? I almost gave some spoilers away because, like, you've seen Kingsglaive.
Yeah.
And you know what happens to his home town. So it's like, come over to my place. And you get there and he's like, oh no. Oh, my dad's dead. I mean, we can still, but I'm going to be pouty. what do I got to do? She gave me the map already, right?
I
think she gave me the map.
I was paying attention to something else.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Oh, geez. All right. This game has one of those. I think Gears of War started this problem of too many things mapped to one button. And it's not a huge issue in this game. It's mainly that, like, the action button is also the jump button. So I will jump in front of things before I do them.
Oh, totally.
Like, frequently in this game. I think I walk in here to trigger them saying, oh, you don't have any money.
Earn Gil.
Yeah, exactly.
Nocto.
A moment.
I saw a meme about this game, and it was like the cost that it takes to fill your tank up in this game versus like the cost of a plate of French fries.
It
was like exponentially
different.
I never
thought of that, yeah. That's so true.
So, like, the economy in this world is amazing.
It's
like how. What am I trying to say? Like,
I don't know. What are you trying to say?
Like, how out of proportion is it?
It was like,
it's like $10 no matter what. 10 gil to
fill
up. Yeah,
so it's like
10
gil versus like 350 gil or something like that
for a plate of fries.
Yeah.
Oh, that's okay. Maybe they just have like an overabundance of fossil fuel or whatever kind of fuel they use.
Maybe it's like corn fuel magic.
Magic, there's
or there's just magic. Like a wicked French fry shortage or potato shortage or whatever they use in this world to make French fries. Also, there's no France in this world.
So like
so they're just fries.
I need to run into that restaurant right now and see if they're called French fries. I gotta find every plot hole. She just gave me 1,000 gil.
Yeah, dude, go buy some French fries.
All right. I mean, technically, she wants me to go kill giant scorpions, but if Scott wants us to buy French fries.
I mean, you can't go kill giant scorpions on an empty stomach.
No, you can't.
You need to preload carbs before you go ahead and try to take on some sand squirts.
I need my stamina bar.
You just, like, dashed.
Yeah, there's a way to do that, and I need my stamina bar to be able to do it deliberately or really good timing. Let's talk real quick. What do you got to tell me? Okay, he knows where camps are. He knows where to park. He knows where he is and other people are. The people who own restaurants are like the tipsters for the area.
Interesting.
And they just, you know, hook you up with all the sweet deals and all that. Oh, he doesn't have fries here.
Look at that, 700 gil for that plate.
Damn. Jambalaya.
Oh, it's jambalaya.
Yeah. And 50 gil for chili, which makes me worry about what's in the chili.
It's just gasoline.
It's just gasoline. It's a bowl of gasoline.
But then why is, like, just gasoline only 10 gil?
All right, should I go fight things next time, or should I give some combat in this episode?
Let's get some combat. Yeah,
if I put it, if I say
if
that
nothing
loud,
else, I gotta see something before we...
All right.
Pause.
Let's go kill something.
All right. So Cindy, in order to get a discount for fixing my car, Cindy wants me, or Sid technically wants me to go take out these bugs.
Oh man, doesn't want to get his hands dirty.
He's giving me a rundown on combat right now, which is hold the circle button to kill.
Well, I'm already enjoying the way this combat looks.
It looks great. It's
It's getting
it
me
gets
excited
deeper
for Kingdom Hearts.
that too.
I'm just so used to seeing the turn-based style combat in the other Final Fantasies that this was like a big surprise to me.
That's one of the complaints that longtime fans have had, but it's, you know, also what kind of makes this one different.
I mean, I'm far from a longtime fan. I dabbled, but...
Well, I mean, you got to consider this game, this series has been around for...
20 years.
Yeah, more than 15 entries, because that's just numbered entries.
But, and the American releases started at different numbers on Japanese releases, too. Yeah. I think the first one to come into the States was, like, Final Fantasy III or something.
Right. But I think they just called it, like, Final Fantasy or something.
Exactly.
Yeah. But, yeah, no, the only ones I really put a significant amount of time into, I think, was 7, 8, 10,
I know.
13, and this one.
So, I never played, but my friend who had a PlayStation 2 played, and he was much better at RPG games, so I would watch him play. And Final Fantasy 10 was definitely... probably one of the most popular ones.
Yeah, absolutely.
At least in my age, like, I know 7 was definitely probably the biggest in the franchise, but
that's the first
I remember 10 the most, for sure.
Yeah. And then 13 wasn't bad either, that was the one with lightning.
Yeah, I played a little bit of it, never finished it.
I don't even remember which one I played, it was so long ago.
You only played one?
No, I want to say it was like, I think 7.
So you gotta kill a bunch of these things.
Yeah, well, this is the last group of them. I did start a new game plus somewhat recently, so some of this is familiar to me. Still.
How's new game plus?
It's actually pretty cool. It's cool to like keep all your stuff, and like it doesn't, like if you've ever played a Souls game, New Game Plus like caters the difficulty or whatever to, or increases it, I guess. When you do New Game Plus, this one doesn't. So when you start New Game Plus,
you feel like a boss.
Yeah, you just destroy everything. Like that's these things die in less than one hit. You kind of just like look at them and they're like, oh man.
I better die.
I better die. Quick.
I'm just
that warp strike is
making
great.
Dudes real sleepy.
Yeah, it gets good, especially when you start like chaining air stuff with warp strikes, which is like there's a whole, obviously there's like a skill tree. I should block that. There's like parries. See, he didn't even come at me then. But yeah, no, it's not that. Whoop. It's not that the combat system is. There's a parry.
Nice. Link strike. Nice.
Yeah, there's some cinematic stuff in the fighting, in the combat, I should say. It's just not. I wouldn't call it terribly deep.
So from what I see, that warp strike mechanic seems to be really useful, but it seems like that's all you would want to do in a fight is just like warp strike in and out to get those damage modifiers.
It does take MP to do it though, which is like a magic meter, so you do have a limited amount, but you can refill it in certain ways.
Right, by hanging
stuff. Yeah, by hanging. But somehow that gets you some like magic.
Watching your bros get beat up by your boss, by a boss.
No, it's cool, I'm just letting my meter fill.
What the fuck?
Just taking a break.
Just getting a little high. All right, so they want us to go find Dave in this cabin. I think we're going to go find Dave next time. Because you got to see some combat. And we're just going to pick this up right from here.
So next time we'll go find Dave.
Yeah, Dave's right over there.
Hang in there, Dave.
Maybe.
We'll be there, maybe.
Eventually, you know.
Oh, was that Dave? Did he just leave?
No.
Somebody call Dave!
Yeah, somebody call Dave, and we'll see you next time. Something's happening.